हेलो गाइज, वेलकम टू आवर चैनल anujindal.in। सो आज के सेशन में आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विद ऑल ऑफ यू द बुक लिस्ट फॉर सेबी 2023। सो इफ यू आर प्रिपेयरिंग फॉर सेबी ग्रेड एग्जामिनेशन 2023, और अगर आप लोग सेल्फ प्रिपरेशन कर रहे हो, खुद तैयारी कर रहे हो एग्जाम के लिए, तो व्हाट आर द सोर्सेज, व्हाट आर द बुक्स विच यू कैन रेफर सो दैट यू कैन कंप्लीट द सिलेबस ऑन टाइम। ओके, बिफोर वी स्टार्ट द सेशन, अ ब्रीफ अबाउट माई सेल्फ। माई नेम इज चेतन। आई हैव डन माई बैचलर्स एंड मास्टर्स इन कॉमर्स फ्रॉम DU। I secured 96.5 percentile in CAT 2016 exam and an All India rank of 3rd in UGC NET Commerce 2018 December attempt. Moreover, I have a work experience of 1.5 years with CAG as an assistant audit officer. So that was a brief about myself. Now, before we start the session, this important information I would like to give you, that we have recently started, I would say, these three live classes for these three examinations, that is RBI grade B, SEBI grade A and NABARD. So all these prestigious jobs, for all these prestigious jobs, we have launched live classes for the aspirants. So for management, ESI, okay. So like if I talk about management and ESI, they will start from 15th July. Then management for SEBI, if I talk about SEBI, so for SEBI, I have started with the classes already, and for management they will be started on 15 July. So this is the entire schedule. I'll provide you the PDF of this. Also the information about these courses, their schedule, or you know, the intricacies of these courses, you can find on our website, or you can also call on our number 9999466225 to get more information about the courses. Then for NABARD, there is ARD syllabus and ESI syllabus. Okay, so for ARD it has already been started, and ESI will be started by Anuj sir from 15 July. Okay, now next I would like to discuss, yes, so before we start, yes, this is an important, I would say, application for all the aspirants, or I would say for all the achievers out there, that they can download and install this application on their mobile phone. This is a very, very helpful application, very, very handy to use. It will aid you a lot in your preparation for different examinations. After that, so today I am going to discuss with you the book list for all the six subjects of paper 2 of SEBI. Okay, Commerce and Accountancy, Management, Finance, Costing, Companies Act and Economics. ठीक है, तो जो लोग those who have enrolled in the courses, they do not need to refer any book, because in the course is already very much comprehensive in itself. Okay, still if you feel कि भाई कुछ extra पढ़ना है, but I don't think there would be much benefit. If you are an enrolled student, then course itself is sufficient. But for those who are preparing on their own, they may refer to the books and the sources which I am going to tell you now. Starting with Commerce and Accountancy. So what I have done is I'll tell you syllabus topic wise. So I have written the topic on the top, okay, and accordingly from which book you can refer which topic. This is how I will tell you. Okay, the book list. First of all, the basic is basics of accounting. Now, this is not mentioned in the syllabus as such, but questions are asked from basics. Okay, basics and accounting as financial information system, this is given. So, this you can cover from class 11th accountancy books, NCRT books. Okay, class 11 NCRT books, this is part 1 and this is part 2. So, part 1 and part 2, from there are two parts of accountancy books as per NCRT. So you can cover both these books for basics. Okay, some of the units you can skip. Okay, like maybe BRS or bills of exchange, you can cover them at the last, but first of all try to cover the basics, like, you know, journal entries, how to pass journal entries, how to, you know, post in the ledger mein posting kaise hoti hai, trial balance, financial statements. Okay, then accounting as financial information system. So first of all try to cover those important topics first. So this is regarding the basic part. Then yes, and to cover basics you can also refer to these books as well. Like this is class 12th, there are actually three parts in NCRT. So this is one, computerized accounting system, you can refer to this. And there are books from other authors for class 11th and 12th, like T.S. Grewal is a very good author, or you may refer to D.K. Goyal. These are, you know, other authors' books which you can refer. Then there is a financial accounting book by J.R. Monga. This is also a good book for, you know, B.com level book. This is a bachelor's level book, but again, for better clarity and for in-depth study, you can refer to this as well by J.R. Monga. Okay, because NCRTs will clear your basics. Okay, that is for basic, but thoda sa advanced padhna hai, toh inko bhi refer kar sakte hai, J.R. Monga. Then after that, next is accounting standards. So you know that there are old AS and there are new Indian AS. Okay, पर्सनली आई फील कि न्यू इंडियन एयर्स आर मोर इम्पोर्टेंट, बट एज अ एस्पिरेंट एज अ स्टूडेंट वी हैव टू कवर बोथ इन दैट केस. सो फॉर द ओल्ड वंस, ओके, सो इन आर कोर्स ऑल्सो वी हैव प्रोवाइडेड द ओल्ड वंस ऑल्सो एंड द न्यू वंस ऑल्सो. ओके, सो वी टॉक अबाउट द ओल्ड वंस, यू कैन रेफर टू दिस बुक बाय टैक्समैन. सो फॉर यू नो टैक्स सब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ लॉ, सब्जेक्ट्स ऑफ टैक्स, बुक बाय टैक्समैन पब्लिशर इज आर जनरली कंसिडर टू बी गुड बुक्स. ओके, सो फॉर दिस इंडियन एएस एंड फॉर एएस देर आर बुक्स अवेलेबल बाय डॉक्टर डी एस रावत बुक्स आर अवेलेबल इजीली इन द मार्केट, यू मे रेफर टू दोस. ओके, अदरवाइज अ लॉट ऑफ मटीरियल इज ऑल्सो प्रोवाइडेड ऑन द वेबसाइट ऑफ ICAI, इंस्टीट्यूट ऑफ कॉस्ट अकाउंटेंट्स ऑफ इंडिया. सो देर इज अ BOS knowledge portal इज देयर. यू कैन रेफर टू दिस टू देयर वेबसाइट टू स्टडी अबाउट अकाउंटिंग स्टैंडर्ड्स एंड अदर टॉपिक्स एज वेल. लाइक इफ आई टॉक अबाउट देयर पेपर वन, देर आर थ्री लेवल्स, फाउंडेशन, इंटरमीडिएट एंड फाइनल. सो इन द फाइनल लेवल ऑफ CA, there is a paper, first paper called Financial Reporting in Group 1. So in this paper, there are accounting standards given. So you can refer to these as well. Okay, I'm giving you certain sources. Some are free, some are paid. You can choose yourself. Then for other topics like cash flow statement, analysis of financial statements, okay, ratio analysis, then you may have fund flow statement. So see, fund flow statement is one topic which is very, very hard to find in the books because जनरली दिस इज नॉट बींग फॉलो टूडे बाय द इंडस्ट्री. पहले फंड फ्लो स्टेटमेंट का यूज होता था सम ईयर्स बैक, बट नॉट नाउ. सो यू मे हैव टू गूगल इट, फंड फ्लो स्टेटमेंट. बट रेस्ट ऑफ द टॉपिक्स लाइक कैश फ्लो, रेशियो, एनालिसिस ऑफ फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट, दिस यू विल इजिली फाइंड इन द बुक्स. ओके, लाइक दिस इज क्लास 12th अकाउंटेंसी बुक्स. ओके, सो इन क्लास 12th देर आर टू पार्ट, वन पार्ट इज फॉर पार्टनरशिप एंड द सेकेंड पार्ट इज फॉर कंपनीज अकाउंट. सो सेकेंड पार्ट यू मे रेफर, दैट इज फॉर कंपनीज अकाउंट. इसमें आपको एनालिसिस ऑफ फाइनेंशियल स्टेटमेंट भी मिल जाएगा लाइक कैश फ्लो, रेशियो, एक्सेट्रा एक्सेट्रा. एंड यू मे ऑल्सो रेफर टू बुक्स बाय TS ग्रेवाल और DK गोयल एज आई टोल्ड यू. ओके, देन देर इज स्टडी मटीरियल ऑल्सो ऑफ ICAI, दैट इज देयर पेपर वन अकाउंटिंग इन द इंटरमीडिएट लेवल. इफ यू लुक एट देयर इंटरमीडिएट लेवल विच इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड IPCC. ओके, सो फ्रॉम हेयर यू मे रेफर टू सर्टेन टॉपिक्स like preparation of financial statements, cash flow, at least these two topics you can easily cover from here. Okay, after that for ratio analysis again you may refer to ICAI website only. There is a paper 8 called financial management and economics, and in that there is a subject of financial management. So in that subject of financial management you will find this chapter number 3, financial analysis and planning ratio. So from here also you can cover ratio. Ratio is also there in your class 12th textbook, or also from, you can also cover from here. Okay, then moving on to the next topic, that is accounting for share capitals, how companies do accounting. That is very, very crucial topic and conceptually difficult somewhat. Okay, but you may refer to these books like class 12th textbook as I told you, and then there is a book of corporate accounting available for graduate level by Dr. by J.R. Monga. You may also refer to this book, right? After that, some remaining topics like bonus shares, right shares, preparation and presentation of final accounts. So for these, again, you may refer to ICAI material, paper one accounting of intermediate level. Here you will find these topics like bonus shares, right shares, okay, redemption of preference shares. So some topics you can cover from this paper one accounting. And yes, these two are also important topics and somewhat new for us. Like employee stock option plan, ESOP, what is ESOP, how the accounting of ESOP is being done, and then buyback of equity shares again is an important topic. So for this again you may refer to ICAI material, paper 5, advanced accounting of intermediate level. Inter level mein hota hai ye. To yahan pe dekho ke aapko mil jayega chapter number 4 mein, chapter 3 or 4 mein, ESOP and buyback. Okay, so these topics can be covered from here, right? Then so that was it regarding commerce and accountancy. Now I'll talk about management. Okay, so how we can cover management. Again, in the syllabus it is mentioned nature, scope, management process and role of manager. This is a very basic stuff. This you can cover from business studies books of class 12th part 1. This is one option, part 1. Okay, second option is you may refer to any elementary management book of graduation level, BBA BCom level. So one is Dr. C.B. Gupta, and there are others by other authors available. Okay, Dr. C.B. Gupta is considered to be a good book. you can cover this book for basics of management. Okay. Then other topics like leadership, motivation, communication, morale, incentives. So these topics come under the ambit of organization behavior, OB. So for OB also, there are various Indian authors, various foreign authors, depending upon how much depth you want to study. Because foreign authors' books are generally more in-depth. Okay. So there is one good book by Indian author, that is C.B. Gupta, Dr. C.B. Gupta. And another is by Stephen Robbins. That is a foreign author book, considered to be a very, very good book for organization behavior. Okay. After that, there is book for human resource management and human resource development. Okay. So in your syllabus, it is mentioned HRD, human resource development, but knowledge of HRM is also important. It is not given, but you have to have knowledge of complete HRM. Like there are two books I have mentioned here. One is by T.N. Chhabra, okay, and one is by K. Ashwathapa. And there is one more book by Gary Diesler and Biju Varke. This is one more book. Okay, I've written it. So basically, I'm giving you options of these three. You can choose anyone. Okay, that is not an issue. Then after that, yes, that completes our management part. Now we'll move to finance. So which books could you refer to for finance? So starting with the financial system regulatory bodies. Okay, so to cover regulatory bodies, that is your SEBI. Okay, what are regulatory bodies? SEBI, RBI, NABARD, etc., etc. Okay, and majorly, so see, for to study about regulatory bodies, you can refer to their websites. That is the best you can do. Otherwise, for to cover the financial system, the components of financial system, there are two very good books. One by Bharti V. Pathak. So these two books are as per Indian context. Okay, Indian Financial System by Bharti V. Pathak or Indian Financial System by M.Y. Khan. These are two good books. You may refer any one of them. Okay, but do take their latest editions, because in finance a lot of changes happen. Okay, so you may get some old data. So for that you have to be very, very cautious ki kuch galat na padh lo aap. Theek hai, thoda dhyan rakhna padta hai self study mein humko. And then financial statement regulatory bodies. Okay, again there is a book by IIBF, Indian Institute of Banking Finance, something like that. Okay, so it has a book of principles and practices of banking, module A. Okay, this is generally recommended for JAIIB exam. But this book has topics like financial system, financial markets, etc., etc. Good book, I would say. Module A talks about financial system. There are more modules to it. Okay. After that, next topic is financial markets, derivatives. Okay. So again, Bharti Pathak and M.Y. Khan you can cover. Apart from that, additionally, you may go through paper 6B, that is Financial Services and Capital Markets of ICAI. Okay, and in that you will find chapter 3 is capital market, primary market. Then chapter 4 is secondary market, then money market, institutions. What are the various institutions in the financial system, various intermediaries. Okay, what is the commodity market, what is mutual fund. So a lot of information you will get here from this module also of ICAI. Then after that, there are some innovative topics which are not easily, you cannot find these topics easily in books. You may have to Google them, or maybe some websites you may have to refer. For example, topics are recent developments in financial sector, okay, like fintech, etc. Then financial inclusion, alternate sources of finance, private and social cost benefit, PPP, public private partnership. So aise topics hain books mein generally nahi mil pate hain. So for that you may refer to RBI website and the FAQs, SEBI website, okay, Niti Aayog website is also a good source. Or you can randomly type the topic in the Google search engine, search box, and then you can find, or maybe you may find some of the topics maybe on the ICAI portal. You have to check for that. After that, what is next? Yes, next is direct and indirect taxes, okay, non-taxes sources of revenue, GST, finance commission, what is finance commission, what is fiscal policy, FRBM act, inflation. So most of these topics are you will find in this book, which I think everybody is aware of, Indian Economy by Ramesh Singh, majorly used for UPSC, used by UPSC aspirants. Okay, but this book contains, I think, almost all of these topics. So I would say you can refer to these topics only. You don't need to cover the entire book. This is a very bulky book. Okay. After that, GST is one such topic, which again you don't have to go into too much detail, because this is not a chartered accountancy paper. They will not ask very detailed questions, very, you know, intricacies they will not ask, but again you have to know the basics, like what is GST, what is reverse charge mechanism, what is input tax, what is output tax. So basics to humko pata hone chahiye, what is compensation, okay, all those. So there is a good textbook by Taxman Publishing House, GST and Custom Laws by Dr. K.M. Bansal. Dr. K.M. Bansal, you may refer to this book by Taxman or maybe some other good book for GST, but make sure it is latest and updated as per the recent amendments. Apart from that, there are some other sources I have written. ICSI, Institute of Company Secretary. Their website also is good website for certain study material. BOS Knowledge Portal, I have already told you. This is of ICAI. Okay, so you can refer to these sources as well. I'll provide you the PDF of this. This is for finance. Now we jump to costing. So what sources you may refer to costing? Okay, so costing ke majority of the topics aapko ek single book mein mil jayenge. That is M.N. Arora. Okay, but some of the topics you may have to Google or you may have to go for other sources also. Okay, like if I talk about M.N. Arora. So you may cover topics like introduction to cost and management accounting, methods and techniques of costing. So methods are different, techniques are different. Okay, then what is budget, what is budgetary control. Okay, and then so for these topics there are some other sources also, like ICAI Knowledge Portal paper number 3, cost and management accounting. ICSI old syllabus book is there, that is for cost and management accounting. There is new syllabus, there is old syllabus. And then ICMAI, that is Institute of Cost and Management Accountants of India. This is different. Chartered Accountant, Company Secretary and Cost and Management Accountants of India. On this website also you will get a lot of material for cost accounting. Specifically for cost accounting you will get a lot of material from their website also. After that there are some other topics like standard costing, budgetary control, lean system. So for these topics generally, especially if I talk about lean system, you may not find it in a general cost accounting book, but for that you may refer to paper number 5 of ICAI, strategic cost management and performance evaluation. And here you will find certain topics like lean system is there. Then you may find something in decision making, I don't know, you may have to check. And then there is cost management techniques, you will have to check in which chapters you are getting the required areas. And then you can also Google certain topics of lean system if you want, right? So that was regarding cost accounting. Now Companies Act, so Companies Act, very specific syllabus has been given to you, chapter 3, 4, 8, 10, 11, 12 and 27. These 7 chapters are being mentioned in the syllabus. And ebook of MCA, I would say it is the best source because it is updated. In Companies Act, we need updated content. And that is the Bayer Act on the MCA website, and specifically the ebook. Because the act which is given, that is not updated, but the ebook is always updated. Okay. Otherwise, you may refer to some good textbook of Taxman, because since it is a law, so a book by Taxman Publishing House would be considered a good book. You can take this book by Professor Anil Kumar, okay, but make sure it is updated as per the recent amendments, or by Dr. G.K. Kapoor and Dr. Sanjay Dhamija, or maybe some other book if you want. Okay. After that, for economics. Now economics comprises of micro, macro and Indian economy. Sab kuch aayega isme. Thoda thoda portion sabse aata hai. So if I first start with microeconomics, that is demand and supply, market structure, or there are some other topics like theory of consumer behavior. Although it is not mentioned in the syllabus, but those topics are important to understand the basics of economics, like theory of consumer behavior or theory of production. Okay, so there is a class 12th textbook for introductory microeconomics. You may refer to this, okay, or you may refer to this graduation level BA BCom level book by H.L. Ahuja, Principles of Microeconomics. This also you may refer, or there is a book by Dr. Deepa Shri also, that can also be referred for introductory microeconomics. Similarly, if I talk about introductory macroeconomics, okay, micro, macro being the two major branches. So the topics in the syllabus are national income, what is consumption function, what is investment function, the concept of multiplier, the concept of accelerator. Okay, and then there is topic like demand and supply for money, balance of payment, ISLM, Phillips curve. So most of these topics you will find in HL Dr. Deepa Shri, introductory macroeconomics, or you may alternatively refer to HL Ahuja book also. It's your choice entirely. You may refer to their indexes, accordingly you may choose. And then class 12th book, Introductory Macroeconomics also can be referred from NCERT website, right? Then after that, yes, there were some more topics of Indian economy, like inflation, monetary policy, fiscal policy, the difference between the two, then non-banking financial institutions, non-banking financial companies, NBFCs. So non-banking financial companies ka data aapko RBI ki website mein mil jayega. Okay, what are those? You may find some FAQs. So RBI pe FAQs hote hain, SEBI ki website pe bhi kaafi sare FAQs mil jate hain. Aur this Ramesh Singh by this Indian Economy book by Ramesh Singh can also be referred, as I told you earlier. Apart from that, ICAI, ICSI and ICMAI study material is always available with you, right? This was, I think, regarding economics. That was the last subject. So I told you the entire syllabus wise books for all the six subjects. I don't think anybody else out there is giving you such a detailed description of topic wise, like which books can be covered for which topic. So do make use of this if you are preparing on your own. See, ek cheez hamesha hoti hai, jab प्रिपेयर खुद करते हैं तो ऑब्वियसली टाइम ज्यादा लगता है, एफर्ट ज्यादा लगते हैं, बिकॉज हमको सिलेबस की इतनी अच्छी नॉलेज नहीं है. सो वी मे एंड अप वेस्टिंग सम टाइम ऑल्सो. ओके, बट इफ यू हैव सफिशियंट टाइम, इफ यू आर नॉट वर्किंग, इफ यू आर यू नो ओनली फोकसिंग ऑन द सेबी 2023 एग्जाम, आपको लगता है आप टाइम निकाल सकते हो और यू कैन डू ऑन योर ओन, देन मोस्ट वेलकम. ओके, यू मे रेफर टू दिस बुक्स इफ यू वॉन्ट, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू प्रिपेयर ऑन योर ओन for SEBI 2023, SEBI grade exam 2023. With that, I conclude my session. If you guys have any doubt or query, you may post the query or doubt in the comment section below this video. I would be more than happy to answer your doubts. Moreover, आप लोग हमारा Telegram group join कर सकते हैं, because the benefit is कि आपकी कुछ query होगी, जो भी query होगा, doubt होगा, आप Telegram group पे डाल सकते हैं and we'll answer that query. Okay, so the link for the group is available in the description below. So guys, agar ye video pasand aaya ho, then do like this video, do subscribe to our channel and share this video with maximum people, so that others also who are preparing for SEBI grade A and want to prepare on their own, they can benefit from this video. So you may post the link of this video on your WhatsApp status, or you may share the link on Facebook, whatever you may like, that's your call. With that, I'll end the session here. So all the very best guys. Take care and have a nice day.